Chiều mùa thu sang con đây mà anh đã ra đi lãng quên tình em. Tình bốn phương những cánh lá còn sơ sát nơi đây trở thành heo gầy. Lòng em hiu hắt băng giá những tháng ngày buồn theo những vết chim bay. Anh đã xa thật xa khi bao yêu dấu còn đây. Lòng này đang muốn rơi xa để quên hết nỗi đau mang trong lòng ta. Cầu mong anh sẽ hạnh phúc, còn em mãi phiêu du dấu chôn tình nhớ. Đành xin yêu mãi mình anh hãy ngồi. Đời phiêu lãng để qua kiếp này, cùng mây gió đi khắp nơi nơi. Tháng năm dần trôi, vì sao anh đã quên hết năm tháng mà ta đã yêu nhau thật đậm sâu. Để em một bóng vai những chiếc lá dùng say héo khô dẫm trên đường về. Còn đâu nữa để tay cầm tay, còn đâu nữa để chia từng cơn vui buồn và trao những chiếc hôn nồng ấm êm đềm.
We have one of the ladies who coordinated the event at UT, because UT, University of Texas at Austin, is the host of this program. So I'll give her the floor for her to talk a little bit about the program. And after that, we will have the fellows to introduce themselves, their names, and just a little bit about what you do and the country that you come from. After then, from then, we move into another. So today is all about networking to these people from Africa and getting to know them. Because a lot of you don't know, right now, Africa is booming. President Barack Obama is in Africa right now for a global school to find out all those opportunities in Africa. And all those opportunities in Africa get from around the world.
Hello everyone, my name is Alicia Cowley. I am the coordinator, program coordinator at the University of Texas at Austin.
Each of the Yale fellows say their names, their country, and a little bit about what they do. The reason being that we want a lot of these highly distinguished people. I think we'll start from here, going like this. So the first is you first.
Hello everyone.
Hello, Tasha.
Some have not responded in which way entirely by using the internet. We provide.
Hello everyone.
Hello.
Same campaign as Asha. Hello everyone.
Hello.
Hi Steve.
Hello.
My name is. My name is Steve. I'm from the Democratic Republic of the Congo. But as I've been telling my fellows for the past 5 weeks,
all right, my name is Jesse Chisi. I'm a filmmaker back home. I run two foundations. One is called Young Cinema in Zambia, and Zambia. We, all of you Africans, you are a torch to tell the world the perception of who we are. You know, there's a lot of innovations, entrepreneurial, educated people in Africa.
Hello, everybody.
Hi.
My name is Melissa Mashunga. I'm from Zimbabwe. I am a social entrepreneur, and I work mostly in rural health and education. We're trying to bridge the gap between urban life and rural life. For anyone wanting to actually come to Africa, I think this is the best stop. The best first stop. For all my fellows, they know they're coming to Zimbabwe next. It's, yeah, very beautiful, lots of... She's another Zimbabwean. Samantha!
Samantha Gama, I'm from
the
south side of Zimbabwe. She's from the north, so we're from
different tribes.
Yeah. So,
hello, everyone. My name is Sebolon David. I'm from Namibia. I'm a technology entrepreneur. I run a technology incubator businesses. Thank you very much. Next person. person is Alokta.
Hi, y'all.
Hi.
I'm Alokta. I'm from Niger, the beautiful country we produce this from for this awesome. Is the one close?
Yeah, one close.
Where?
I'm from Mali.
Oh yeah. Yeah, brothers.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Shane. I'm from South Africa. I'm a film director, entrepreneur, and husband. That's what it says in my Twitter profile, so I was trying to keep it short. That's the plan. And then, thank you. And then I'm also working on a project called Cinebox. It's kind of like Cinnabon, but it's a box. And to bring cinema to the people in South Africa, because cinema is still very much for the minorities like myself. And before I sit down, Steve over there, before I get up, I don't know why I said, I must tell everyone that he is single.
Hello everybody. Hello. I'm Simbom also. I'm Oshimaino Akoshla. Two islands in West of Africa. Saint Omer and Brixby. Then I run a company, service provider company. We make maintenance and repair in power generator, AC, thing like this. Some.
Some genius.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sam Kodo. I'm from Togo. Togo is one of small country in West Africa and also beautiful country. I have one friend here.
Everyone, I know it's only our name, but I'm a Chinese. Anyway, I'll tell you a story. I was in Asia 2 years ago and then in Taiwan. When you get there, they ask you to change your name because they cannot pronounce English name. So when I got there, then my name was changed from Lang Lu to Lien Long. And I'm from the Gambia. The Gambia is a very small country in West Africa. And very beautiful country. And because I'm an instructor in information systems. And then last year I started an incubator and it's called T-Innovation Hub, where we bring in young people in technology and allow them to collaborate, create, and innovate. And to see all of you. Thank you. Marianne from Ghana.
Okay. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
My name is Marianne Ramaredu.
From Ghana.
Yes, I'm from Ghana, the land of gold. And I'm a land economist. I run a land consultancy business in Ghana, so if you are looking to buy land, property in Ghana, you can see me. I'm a social entrepreneur. I run a non-profit business organization that is into IT education. We educate young people from the age of 6 to 35 years. We give them, because we want to break the gap, the digital divide. And we are more focused on the rural communities, because that's where we realize that they are lacking. Because you find them, some of them have never seen computers before. It's real. And I like to call my neighbor. My neighbor from Niger.
I think you should be able to call. I get that. In every African setting, 1 in 4 people there are Nigerians. Really? Okay, you're from Niger here, please. Sure. Nigeria's first internship placement organization, and it's called Sheshewa. For Yoruba people, it means, is there a job? So we provide internship opportunities for young, you know, students in Nigeria who have not been to Africa. Okay. Let me call my parents.
My name is Kezi. I come from the only country that I am told has got 2 sitting presidents.
Different
parts of the world. I'm a lawyer by profession, just like this, I'm from Nigeria. But I do run a company that does corporate event management. And what we do, I'm not a social entrepreneur. I see opportunity and I simply convert that opportunity for financial gain.
Yes.
We find a way to get those finances to the community. That's how I have impact on my think a critical economic.
The way right now.
Okay.
Hello everyone, I want to start by thanking you for taking time out of your busy weekend and come talk to us and work with us.
You're welcome.
Appreciate that. My name is Mohamed Bena, I'm from Mauritania. I am a university lecturer, I teach linguistics. I also work as an interpreter and a translator, and I'm planning to start my own translation company. And but Mauritania is one of the most beautiful countries, of course, ever. we have the longest sandy beach, I can say, in Africa. It's very beautiful. We have so many sand dunes, and we have camels. We have so many beautiful things. Thank you.
Camels on the beach.
Hello, everyone. My name is Nozi Paul from South Africa. The Mandela Washington Fellowship Program is named after our late former president. So that's how important South Africa is. Okay, I'm a fine artist by profession. For the past 7 years, I've worked for a nonprofit organization which uses arts and craft to help people who are economically marginalized and are not earning a living. So we identify people in rural areas and township communities, and we improve their arts and craft skills, and then we give them access to markets so they can earn sustainable income. So we work with more than 600 artists and crafters around the eastern region of South Africa. Doing that for the past 7 years, and now I've also identified a need. I realized that young people who have reading and learning disorders are being marginalized, and I think I can still use art and craft to liberate them, and they can also find themselves and also start their own arts and craft businesses. So that's what I want to do.
So I really applaud all these guys for planting a seed, maybe in the political section, in the entrepreneurship section, in the business. Let's put another round of applause. Next, we want, as ALTV5, if some of you are not familiar with ALTV5, one of our major missions is to empower people through media. We really want people, if you can turn on the television and learn how to be a Turk, we want you to turn the television and learn how to be a king. And learn how to be somebody creating stuff, and learn how to see other people doing stuff in Africa and around. So we really want to introduce some of the people who are in AFTV5, who are involved in AFTV5, and as I just call your name, please, can you just come off the stage and say a little bit about yourself. First, we will start with somebody who is the brain box of all this, and if he wasn't here, we wouldn't have been in this platform. So let's give a hand of applause to our founder, Mr. Samuel.
So grateful to be here today with yours. So you can hear about Yali coming to UT and send an email to UT telling them that look at our website and see our vision. That was the kind of vision we have for Africa, supporting young, talented leaders to change Africa. So I wrote to them, tell them we would love to get involved and doing anything we can to support these leaders. And that's how we get to know them. Since they came here about 5 weeks ago, I met with them three times. The last time that I met with them, about 2 days ago at the UT, they were doing their pitches they were pitching their businesses out. I cried. I listened to these guys. I know how, I saw how young they are. And then sometimes I start cheering my eyes. Because that's why Africa, that's what I know about Africa. The kind of people I know that Africa can produce. I'm not going to do a speech here. I want you all to meet these people, talk to them in our community here in Austin. I thought it would be a great opportunity for them to talk to, you know, people in the community who have ambition, because Africa, in the next few years, going to be power in this world. And I want African-American in this country to look in Africa. And these are the people to connect with. And that's the only reason I thought maybe we can start helping make that connection. That's the only reason we're here. No speeches. And that's, again, grateful for the University of Texas for letting us, you know, have this network. And we hope in the future to, you know, be involved and work with these unions. Again, I'm just telling you now, I met two people there that do film, and a producer. If we can help in anything, we're ready to hold that. Again, thank you so much for coming tonight. And
now let's go to a board of our directors. I would like to introduce Bill Rogers. On my left, Bill Rogers, can you come on stage, please? Thank you.
Good afternoon. Thank you so much. I want to say thank you for everybody who came in the house today. My name is Bill Rogers. I'm a young man from Liberia. You know, everybody from Africa came here for a few reasons. Some people say, will not enter the United States, I'm going for the Mercedes-Benz. That's why I'm going to drive. We have those people. Some people say, when I enter first, I'm going to get a bling-bling chain. I'm going to be like flip-a-flip. Me, I say, when I come in the country, I will run and I won't pay no school fee. And I want to say thanks to AFTD who found my talent too by being mentor, inspiring to me. He had joined me in Africa on some of my mission. Liberia is just a small little country, but we're rich, but our people are selfish. Be honest with you, for me standing here tonight, I want to make a great change in my nation, Republic of Liberia. The only honor for any young man in the house for your country to give you the authorization to address the nation. That's where I feel that I am someone today. That the president said, address the nation. I stood up. I could announce myself, ladies and gentlemen, today I'm the president of the Republic of Liberia. But they believe in me. They believe in me, and they gave me hope and gave me that accreditation. So I want to say thank you for having me here. And I want to do more. I know when you pay $5,000, I can pay $1,000. And my $1,000 stuff can be more productive than your $5,000 you spend. Thank you so much.
She was also our board of directors. She was standing right there. Her name is Mimi. She left to take care of one urgent thing. Can we give a hand of applause for her?
Today. I'm Queenie Trimbles from AOTV5. This is my boss, Sam. So we're out today just to connect with you guys and interview some of you guys that have been picked to go see Barack Obama. And we're here to impact and just network and do a little bit of documentary work here and just have a good time and fellowship and whatever we have to go here. So we're out here to talk to you guys and get to know you guys and connect. So we're happy to be here. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ibrahim Maiga. I'm from Mali. I live here for 6 years. I just have a question for this guy from South Africa. I don't know why do. So you say you guys are making movie, right? So I want to know when the movie come out, how we as Africans who live here can see it.
Mainly going to be through film festivals.
So somehow, through the mailing networks, and then we can let you know what film festival it's going to be in. You'll probably catch it that way. Ultimately, it'll be online through some streaming service, but those deals will be done once the film's done. So ultimately, it'll be aiming at the big film festivals, because it's so we're not 100% sure yet. But also, I just saw Nollywood sign a deal with Netflix that you can get Iroko TV now. Yeah, is going to come to Netflix.
I have a lot of Africans stuff in Africa about Don Organ stuff, you know. So it's a weird story. We want to see it as Africa.
Mm. Yeah.
That's it. So yeah. I just want to know how can we get to...
Board member with the Greater Austin Black Chamber of Commerce, and also a board member with the Black Professional Alliance, which is made up of the different major Black organizations. Because some of you might fall in love and talk to some people too long than others. But we definitely want to stay in contact with all of them and one day see all these beautiful countries.
Hello, hello. I'm Ihaya Chugu. I actually just moved to Austin back in February. I'm a software engineer over at IBM Watson over in the north side. So I'm actually like kind of curious. So my parents are from Nigeria, but it's interesting because really there's a lot of mentorship to be had in America, but I'm wondering if there's a way of like if anybody's really tackling the problem.
Okay. Well, there's several programs going on right now in Nigeria. Sheshawa is one of those, you know, programs. We have mentoring opportunities where we have someone who has walked the walk, talk to people who are just aspiring to become. So I'll get your contact and get in touch with you. And if any other person is interested in, you know, being that, you know, idol, so to speak, to that young person.
Before I forget, on your question, so in a couple of weeks, they invited me to speak at the United Nations. I'm speaking at the annual Millennium Campus Conference at the United Nations, and I'm speaking based on what you just answered. It's about how young people in Africa can get that direct access with mentorship in the United States. They're bringing together student leaders from 50 countries, so I'll address those students. So I'll get your card also, I can keep you in line with that, all right?
Okay, my name is Chuck Sunyeke. I'm African American, and originally I'm from Nigeria. So I'm one of you. I live here, and I own a business here. Roger, my friend, invited me to come here. So I have spoken to a few of you here, and I'm really very grateful. So first of all, I want to thank God for the opportunity that we have somebody who could make this possible. And what I would say to any one of you here, so count yourself as lucky, because you were selected among many. So do not misuse this opportunity. Use it to help yourself and help your people. And I want to talk in general to those people that involved in nonprofits. I worked with the US government for several years, and the government gives money to what is called the US aid to nonprofit organizations. Some of them are to developing countries like countries in Africa. So if you do that, I want to get information from you if you're involved in nonprofits.
Okay.
Maybe that way there's an opportunity here to give grants to any country in Africa. I can get in touch with you.
But, good one day.
But bear in mind, I'm from Nigeria, I'm from Africa. Woo! And I live in America, I work with the US government. The way businesses are done in both places are different. So if you are going to receive any grants or money from here, be sure to account for everything.
That's
it. So I'm a global chapter of accountant, so I'll help you do that, but if you're not willing to live according to the law, don't call me.
So I have a story. I'm going to start by KZ. You probably know about the Airlift program. So it's very fitting we're talking about Kenya here. So the Airlift program was started by Tom Mboya back in the 50s. And it basically the program that eventually made Barack Obama Sr. come to the United States. And the rest is history. And his son is now back in the rest is history. I think about that. So I'm on the board of director of the African Leadership Bridge. What we essentially do, we do the opposite. We actually select and identify young African students that went to school in Africa. And we actually provide full tuition for them to study in the US for 4 years. beyond money, well, money I think is always the easy part, although it's hard to raise. I think the easier, harder part is really mentorship. I think because many of us have come here at 18, 17, we have all the dreams to go back to Africa and then life happens, right? You get married and you want to drive a nicer car and electricity, all the things that you know about, as opposed to going back, right? So but the reality is that we're making a difference here because we select students out of the African Leadership Academy in Johannesburg. So most of the South Africans know about ALA. And actually, after being here in the US for 4 years, they either go to grad school, but the whole point is that they have to go back home. So two former students right now, one is from the DRC. He's back in Angola right now. The second one actually just went back. He's from Kenya. He just went back after just finishing a full 2 year master program at Harvard, free ride again. So the interesting part about it, where I see the connection, I see two connections here. I see two connections. One is opportunity for folks here that live in the United States, live in Austin or Oklahoma State, can actually connect with these students because again, most of the students will come in, they're gonna be here for 4 years and they're all gonna go back. Every summer, they all go back pretty much. So I see an opportunity here for them to assimilate themselves to the American culture so they can actually take the best of both worlds. And the second connection back, I think, I see a connection with all of you guys back in Africa because we want them to go back, right? So for example, the last student we have, he has a 2080 SAT, just got into UT, studying RTF. So that's an opportunity for him potentially to connect with you about ways for essentially do filming here, potentially with you guys. But really, as he goes back to Africa, other opportunity for him to start basically setting his grounds there. The biggest thing essentially is that if you come here and stay for a long time, your roots essentially are getting disconnected. It's harder for you to go back. And the second thing, so I guess one is mentorship while they're here in Austin. The second thing, which obviously is connection back as they're driving, as they're going back to all the countries. Out of the five students we have right now, we have four countries represented: Nigeria, Egypt, South Africa, and Congo, and Kenya as well. So again, I try not all of Cameroon. I try very hard not to discriminate. I think the only criteria is that if you're very smart, you have high grades. More importantly, if you have a passion to go back, and you know, we'll probably will take a look at the application. But again, thank you very much for all you guys are doing, and thank you.
Okay. Is it recording now?
Yes.
Okay. Hello and thank you for watching AFTV5. I am Kenicha Lewis here reporting. Hello and thank you for watching AFTV5. I am Kenicha Lewis here reporting. Today, AFTV5 is out in Austin, Texas at the Holiday Inn at the Mandela Washington Fellows. Today, AFTV5 has young leaders from the UT and Austin are here today representing the YALI Network. YALI stands for Young African Leaders Initiative. Nearly 1 in 3 Africans are between the ages of 10 and 24, and approximately 60% of Africa's total population is below the age of 35. President Barack Obama launched YALI in 2010 to support young African leaders as they spur growth and prosperity, strengthen democratic governance, and enhance and secure across Africa. AFTV5 is hosting YALI for the networking and the opportunity to meet and connect with Africans all over Austin, Texas.
Okay. The country makes about $6 billion. It comes here, they make $65 billion from it. That is so lopsided. I can go on and on and give you some of these figures. And I'm probably just going to inundate you with more than you need. But what I'm trying to say is that I'm looking at young entrepreneurs here. I'm very proud of you. When I came here, there's nobody like you here. When I finished school, I wanted to go into business. I had no idea where to turn. You have to know how to do business in order to be a business person. We didn't have people to help us, to just for us to piggyback on their tail. You have it. Please, don't be consumers. Create something. Yeah. Otherwise, you're going to work very hard. When you sit down and do the math, for those of you who are in accounting, the balance sheet doesn't balance. Because somebody here is making more money from your product. We have more natural resources in that continent than anywhere in the world. I'm not bragging here, this is a fact.
Yeah.
And if we don't do something about it, somebody's going to come and take those resources, bring it here, develop it, and sell it back to you, multiples more than what you sold it to them. I, you know, my thing, some of my question goes to this. If somebody wants to go to a place like Africa to do business, what kind of resources do we have? These are things we can do to say, okay, and I know that might be some of the things you talked about doing at the UN, but it would be very helpful to have like a clearing house. You go there, you know what to do. So people want to do that, but they are blind, they're groping around. And that would be very helpful where you know you can tap into a centralized or a well-coordinated information where you can say, okay, this is how I do what I need to do. That would be very helpful. And, you know, I'll be talking to you before I leave because there are some of you, I'm very excited. Same thing with Marianne, you know, and I think that's bringing hope to us. Even if I can establish it, I wish that I can do something that somebody will come up and write on because we have talented children here. I don't care where you go. Harvard, name the university, matter of fact, the world, you will find an African person and they're doing very well. And these people are staying back. You know why the United States is growing very well? They know how to absorb people that go to school here. Let's do that in Africa.
When thank you.
Keep them. Yeah. Give them a challenge. Keep them here. Let them go to the continent for you. Otherwise, we are still going to be consumers. I'm tired of it.
I'm getting back to the questions. I know some of you are talking about opportunities in Africa, opportunities in the United States. For some of you who don't know, last year we did AFTV5. We hosted the African Cultural Award Night, and it turned out to be very great. So this year, in November 19th to the 21st, if I mark the calendar, we are doing the annual cultural award and business matchmaking event here in Austin. And what we're doing, we're bringing business owners from Africa and bringing business owners here in the United States so they can collaborate, they can look for those opportunities, and they can take back those opportunities and build it either in Africa or in the United States. So it's a business matchmaking event. You want to mark your calendar on that. And if you go to AFTV5 website, you go to our event, you can be able to find out more information on that. If you need specific information, you can see me anytime from here, and I can highly give you more information on that. One great thing I want to tell the guy who talked about the opportunities in Africa. So the Global Entrepreneurship Summit is currently going on in Africa. How it works is the U.S. administration took a lot of investors, a lot of business people back in Africa. The event also featured the Tony Elumin Foundation in Nigeria. They are looking for those great opportunities in Africa. I have one of the ladies who works directly there. She's one of the organizers. So she will send over to me a report of all the opportunities that these business people have talked about that Africa have. And at our business matchmaking event, we're going to bring out those opportunities and see how we bring them over here. If you're a business owner in the Austin area or internationally, make sure you stick in our calendar so we would really love to have some.
Jumbo, Shay Dada Mio. Hi, everybody. My name is Latanya Pagese. I'm a business owner here in Austin, Texas. I am from the United States of America. So welcome to our country and all the wonderful heat. Woo, it's hot out there. But I'm a proud graduate of Howard University. So the gentleman who just spoke prior to me, I think some of our Howard alum are actually going back to the continent and making a difference there. But my business is actually an interesting one that I do international marketing and have worked in international markets all across the world except for my native Africa. So I'm really excited about the opportunity to engage with you all. I've actually sent people to Africa to do work on projects, but unfortunately I haven't had the pleasure of attending myself. But one thing that I would love to see Boko and Samuel, if possible, is some type of, this is my country, this is my name, this is my email, and these are the opportunities that I'm looking for. Because I know a lot of us, we have things that come across our desk all the time. And it would be great if we had some type of like a, not necessarily directory or database or just something that we can have. So as it comes, and maybe even those of us in the United States as well. So if we see opportunities for partnership, that might be a faster way. I hear people individually saying that they're interested in having their business cards exchanged, but I think a lot of us are interested in some of the same topics. So if that's a possibility, that would be so great, okay? Thank you. Thanks, Shay.
Actually, thank you for all the questions, but I was discussing with my fellows here, and I think we also have a question for you guys. We all coming from Africa. Some of us live there, and some live here. But more often than that, we have the feeling that people living here in the US or not living in Africa have let us down.
Okay.
I mean, honestly.
Thank you for that, sir.
Because, you know, I'm very proud to see all of these African brothers and sisters, diseducated, successful, but the real question is, to the exception of a few people I've heard today, what are you really doing for Africa? It seems sometimes easier for me to partner with an American citizen than with my African brother living here. You guys, you rose, but you forgot where you risen from. And that hurts sometimes. A lot of us living there, we live there by choice. A lot of people have studied in the UK, in Australia, and went back to Africa, not because they were deported, because they wanted to. There's nothing wrong with living here. There's nothing wrong with being part of the diaspora. There's nothing wrong with that. But the real question is, what is life expecting from me? What is Africa expecting from me? I think that's the question we should all ask ourselves. And once we form that synergy, when we become a whole, because we have been working in silos. We have Africans living in Africa and the diaspora. It's like two different groups. The real question is, how do we get together and do something? But that's my opinion. I think we don't trust each other.
We never do.
I think we don't trust each other.
There is an answer. We have an answer for you. I have an answer.
No problem, sir.
We have a lot of answers for you.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not a debate. I just want us to think of it. It's great that you all are here, but I would like all of us to ask ourselves that question. What can I do? And when you know what you can do, let me do it. Thank you very much. It is not a debate, and I didn't want to make anyone feel uncomfortable. I just wanted to raise it because I may be wrong, but that is the feeling we are sometimes having. Thank you very much, guys.
Congo press. Thank you. I've been trying to get my hand up, but my height somehow is. But you know how you know that somebody is your brother? They think the way you do. He hit it right on the head. But my question is this: from a branding perspective, you want to do business or you attract business to yourself if you're well packaged and well branded, isn't it? Africa, we are young, you know, budding entrepreneurs, and we're trying to get our message across the world. But Africa has been incorrectly branded. And sometimes we want to blame the media, and of course the media has, they've got their ratings or their targets, and that's what they will call Kenya hotbed or whatever. And that's not my issue. The most disturbing thing is the contribution of the African diaspora in misbranding Africa. And I'll give you two examples. Yesterday I had some interaction with an American acquaintance that I met here, and she said she recently visited Nigeria for the first time.
I'll stand up for
this. Let me say this, because when all is said and done, some stuff has got to be said, isn't it? She recently visited Nigeria, and when she came back, her roommates are Nigerians. When she came back, she told her roommates, you know what, guys? The Nigeria you've been describing here is not the Nigeria I saw. I found a beautiful, budding, vibrant Nigeria. Isn't that the Nigeria you know? And much to my shock and horror, yesterday I sat through listening to BBC, somebody interviewing Kenyans living in the diaspora. And guess what the Kenyans had to say? Oh, we are so shocked. The kind of police brutality that goes on in that country. They live in the diaspora. And what this person interviewing them wants to know are, what are the opportunities in your country? And we just want to challenge you guys. Help us brand the continent correctly. If I live in the US, or I'm an American, like my friend here, Alicia. And all I tell her is how Ebola and malaria is killing those people over there. That's what she's going to know. She doesn't even need to tune in to CNN. That's what she's going to know. We are asking you. You guys are ambassadors for the continent. Help us brand that continent correctly. I'm going to say one more thing. African nations, my nation especially, the other day I know that the Kenya had a diaspora conference going on in Dallas. The governments are spending money to come to this part of the world to talk to the diaspora about the opportunities happening there. Guess who is taking up those opportunities? It's not you guys. It's the white community. They know what's going on in Africa, and they're stepping in there, so it's between us and them. Where is the African diaspora? We're challenging you guys. In all humility, take up your place. You are in here, you can correctly brand the continent, and more so, you can be forefront in taking up the opportunities in the continent right now.
Can you give me just 2 minutes? I want to give him a little answer.
Yeah, me too.
I like what you said. It's very interesting. And some people come in America to study. Something happened, they stay. They can't go back. Maybe the company send them to have the degree, disappear in Africa. Why? I saw somebody here, he said $175,000. He came here with a visa and he don't want to go back. But he don't have a green card. He just worked in a restaurant here, do this, you know. And he said he went in Africa. He's not an African that left the place. And the power, the government over there, you don't know who is who. You're gonna be the future leaders over there. You gotta change the way the leadership is. And you can go over there, you wanna jump into something, somebody wants some money. What this one wants some money. You just keep giving away the money. And you never did the business you wanna do, and the people you're giving the money, you don't know where they are. They can send you a land that already sold to somebody. You see, so this is something you have to know. We have to fix home first. And then when it's fixed, we can come, we can land down.
So you can come back with us.
Thank you so much for all the questions. I think from my own end, the way I see Africa is more of less the positive people bind up together and try to do great things. Some of you may not understand. I prefer to be in a plane with somebody who have a whooping cough than to be locked in a room for 20 minutes with somebody who is negative. That is the way I do my thing. The reason why I say that is because when I came to this country, I took like a first year. I've been here for about 3.5 years. I was in D.C. And in D.C., I had the chance to do events even with Barack Obama. They invited me a couple of times to do events for that. And after I had a grant to come over to Austin, when I came here, it was an African who had to house me. But ladies and gentlemen, I came here with so positive mindset, trying to do things. One day he came out, locked the door, and wrote on a piece of paper that, take your positivity and look for where to stay. He was an African. But today I'm blessed. Like he sees me only just on the internet. You know, he texts me, I can't reply. But I had the chance, you know who did something for me? I went to a networking event and I had a chance to talk to positive people.
Yeah.
And they say, young man, you have a talent, I'll do something for you. And that is what I've gotten me today, where I am. So I believe Africans, we just need to bind together our people who are positive,
yes,
want to make change, and you will not complain about anything because there's a lot of positive people in Africa. You just want to continue to bind together. So because of what the young guys are doing in Africa, we decided AFTB5 to give just a certificate of excellence to what you continue to do in Africa. And we really want to thank you for making a difference in your life. Because of you, Africa will never be the same again. I can assure you that. And I know we're missing a couple of you guys, but as I call your name, please, can you just come here and get a little certificate from AFTB5? Asha.
My number one is my number one.
Mohammed. Alicia, can you come please? So we decided to give a flag to Alicia.
I'm proud of you being I wish everybody could be this. Cho má hồng anh mãi mê nâng niu vài ngày nào biết tim em nỡ quên vội anh dòng đời ôi bóng tối vây quanh anh hỡi dù vẫn biết đêm nay tình nồng chân gối người ấy sẽ cho em một đời nhung gấm dù vẫn miên mà những lúc mưa đêm sao con tim em bồi hồi chợt nhớ đến môi hôn năm xưa ôi sao tuyệt vời từng nỗi nhớ vu vơ trong em từng góc phố ánh mắt bao dung đam mê cho em ngọt bùi giờ cũng đã xa rồi mình em còn trái tim ăn năn nhớ năm tháng xưa mặn nồng anh thiết tha cuộc tình ân cần gọi nắng cho má hồng anh mãi mê nâng niu vài ngày nào biết tim em nỡ quên vội anh dòng đời ơi. We're here at the Mandela Washington Fellows. We're here with Steve Zita. Yes, and Steve has been chosen to be one of the ones to go to Washington to meet President Barack Obama. Is that right, Steve? All right, so we're here to ask Steve some questions today. So the first question, we're going to talk about YALI. Okay, so what is this program doing for you, and can you tell us a little bit about YALI?
Actually, it's the White House and the Young African Leaders Initiative called the Mandela Washington Fellowship. There are 500 young African leaders have been selected among 1,000 Africans to come in the U.S. in various tracks. Some of them have been selected to attend the Business and Entrepreneurship track, some others in public administration, and other civic leadership. So we've been placed in various universities in the U.S. for academic coursework, leadership sessions, and some side business networking events like this one to meet with people
feel about being President Barack Obama?
It's not like every day that you can meet someone who has written history, not only for his country, but for the entire, I would say, African community. You know, it's just him. Thank you all. I remember in November 2008 that when I was elected, and in January, we were watching the news, and you know, in Africa, it was like we just won Soccer World Cup. People were counting, so being invited by someone like that who has been a part of history, not only for his own country, you know, it goes back to what Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was saying, 1968, he had a dream, that dream coming true, and today, Mr. Barack Obama, who lived in Africa potential, and therefore in Africa's youth, inviting us over is priceless. So I feel proud, honored, and a little nervous.
Okay. Well, as we said, AFTB 5, that YALI stands for Young African Leaders. So I've been talking a little bit with Mr. Zita, and you have a little bit of dreams of your own. You want to go back to Africa, to your hometown, correct? Tell us a little bit about your country and why you feel like you want to be in that position. You know, anyone that has that position of president sees issues in their city, their town. What are the issues there that you want to see changed?
Actually, that's where I never see issues.
Really?
I see things that can be improved, things that can be changed. And I believe in Africa. And even more than that, I believe in my country. In my beautiful country, I believe in Congo, I believe in Kinshasa, I believe in the people there. This country has so much potential that if we all, you know, I'm not here to talk about my country's governance. We have issues. I'm sure that people who are there are trying to work on those issues, to fix those issues. I'm sure the president there is government, they're working on those issues and everything, but it's not solely their work. I think all of us, Congo sons and daughters, we have to do that. We have to do something. So, as much as I can do, I will. It's all about believing people. I personally work with the youth just to make sure that this generation who will run the country tomorrow will have something to say, something to do, the right attitude, and yeah. So it's all about believing. I hope some people say it's very difficult. You know, Africa has been what it has been, and I compare it to building a wall. You know, you don't just come there and say, I will build a perfect wall. You don't say that. But you say, I will lay every brick as perfectly as a brick can be laid. And soon, you have a wall. So I think we all have to bring our brick, the wall we're building, and let's see what it gets. But what is sure is that I will do my part.
I believe, Mr. Zita, you have summed
you
it up.
You can call me Steve.
Yes, I can call you Steve. But Mr. Zita, thank you so much for letting us have time to talk to you. And you have summed it up so well. And so we just thank you on the behalf of AFTB 5 to be shaking Mr. Zita's hand, and we'll be shaking Barack Obama's hand pretty soon, going to the Washington White House. So this is pretty cool. Thank you. Thank you so much.
I think now I can get everybody over here.
Thank you.
Jesse Chisi, and you are from
Zambia.
Zambia, and you are a film director, is that right?
Yes, I'm a film director.
Okay, and you are a fellow.
And fellow.
Under YALI, and we've been talking about YALI, Young African Leadership Initiative.
Yes.
And she is one of the ones that are going to meet Barack Obama, President Barack Obama. How do you feel about that, by the way?
It's exciting. I've been long waiting.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you have any questions you want to ask him?
Literally, for me, I'm interested in the focus of entrepreneurship for young women and youth, which obviously is embracing as much, like, so how we can sort of create the lineage, the foundation, strong foundation, not rather like, okay, we give you grants, then you go with it, but how can we create partnership between the US and America, first of all? I think that's what we need, partnership, and that can grow. Then we have sort of both mutual interests.
And you are under UT,
UT,
under the YALI program that President Barack Obama has created in 2010. So how is this program helping you as an individual?
Well, as an individual, on an individual level, it's helping me to make with other businesses in America, how they have done. Obviously, they're very different, but I'm getting some sort of idea of how businesses work in America. And also, it helps me as a leader to focus on certain issues that really need co-focus. And when I go back home, I know exactly what to take from this and tell I make it for Zambia.
Okay. And you mentioned that you are a film director. Have you did any films? Are you in the makings of making anything?
I've done films. I've just released my first feature film, which is Between Rings. About a woman, you know, for me, this film is about running in Africa, because many times the perception of Africa and how it's looked at from the rest of the world is in the poverty, famine. And in this film, I wanted to show resilience, tenacity, a powerful woman that comes out of this environment. It's not perfect, but there's a lot of perfect things around it,
yes.
You know. So this is what the film is about. It's about Zambia's first female boxer, who comes from rags to riches, and then becomes a household name and motivates. And these are images we need to see that actually there's people making a difference in Africa, like for themselves, for their families, for their communities. And these are the stories we need to see, because an African story cannot be told one-sided. Has to be told from
Africa's point of view. Okay. So you have big dreams.
I have big dreams. Which is Africa
Kid. Yes.
Like that's like my new venture. Like I want to just document successes across Africa and feature them online and so show the innovations, the ideas, the education, the people that are coming out of Africa, like to paint that, the eco-markets, how they're working, and how literally we can just find opportunities. Like Africa, in its many problems, that is, and this is what Africa wants to embark on.
I think this is amazing. You know, Barack Obama is actually from, is he from Kenya, I believe?
From Kenya?
I have no idea.
Okay. Kenya, his father's Kenyan descent, but his mother's American.
Okay.
So Kenyan descent, but he's American.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you feel any type of connection, just the fact that you share a background,
with
just kind of,
Obama.
Yes, just the fact that he has a part of Africa, just a part of him that is from Africa.
I think Obama represents the very core of what every human being wants to see, which is equality. He represents opportunities. He represents that nothing can limit you. It's not about race, about color. As long as you're intelligent, you've got a goal, you've got a vision, you can lead. He represents the very values of what Martin Luther King stood for.
Yes.
It's for me, when I see him, I see a lot of a different world, and that we've transcended from there, and now we're here, and the future is bright. So when you are associated with that kind of human being on that level, it motivates you, like a president with that caliber recognizes you, you can even do more as a young person.
Well, thank you so much, Ms. Chisi, for coming out. I believe that you have a very good gift, and you're getting ready to excel, get to that next level, going to Washington, this is going to be empowering and impacting for you. I believe this is going to drive you more with your passion of filming, going back to your hometown and just having endless possibilities.
Of course. I mean, for me, just being in the same environment with 500 young people,
yes,
with different ideas, but going after the one goal of development is just unprecedented. It's it's overwhelming just to see this energy, like,
yes,
literally it takes you back to being like, okay, I'm representing my country, but I want to take this to every young person that I meet and share with them, and they should share with 10 other people. Like, I just don't want to hold this to myself. I want to influence 10 people, 20 people themselves. Then through that, we create a network of positivity and create positivity.
Okay, well, thank you so much for coming out, and AFTV5 is happy to be here, to be able to talk to you guys and just have the condominiums and just networking, cultural, all of it's just a beautiful thing through today. And I thank you for coming out once again. And I just hope that your trip to Washington is amazing and is all that you wanted it to be. I just couldn't think of, oh my gosh, Barack Obama's getting ready to walk into the room. I want to follow up with you if we can later on and see what we can talk about if that's possible.
Definitely. I mean, because of the TV series, I'm definitely thinking, I love to be talked to like family people, how we show them green, because it's not, Africans know their story, their real story, but rest of the world don't know. So when we document these positive stories, who are we making the stories for ourselves to be reminded and for generations to come, but also for the world to understand.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so through the TV station, we
create that. Thank you so much. And we thank President Barack Obama for creating YALI for you guys and be able to bring in young leaders, African leaders, all around the world, be able to network and connect. And I believe in the future, there are going to be some more amazing networks coming in. So I thank you for being under here and coming with us today. And this is AFTV5, and I'm Quinny Lewis.
So, what you do here in the U.S.?
I work for a company called National Instruments. We make electronics-based products for test and measurement. So, I've been working there for about almost 10 years now.
So, you're an engineer?
I'm an engineer.
Okay. And what?
In electrical engineer.
Electrical engineer. So, this event today, what are you here for, sir?
I was here for the YALI event, which is an opportunity to connect and network with some of the young African leaders in that part of the program. So, this is my second year meeting with them, and every time you walk away feeling very inspired and very excited about the work that you guys are doing.
So what did you learn about this event today?
What I've learned today is I actually was very challenged. The one thing that leads me here today, I was challenged by one of the fellows to really understand how do we basically move things forward to the African diaspora. I think that's the one thing that I learned that I'm going to take back and say, it's not enough for me to sit back here and actually just live a comfortable life. I think it all comes down to finding ways to continue to help and support, because I think at the end of the day, you can't follow where you come from.
So how was the event?
It was the event involved was very well put together. I like the structure of the event, the opportunity to understand from every panel. But again, overall, very, very well done event. Thank you.
So would you like to see this thing happen again, this kind of event?
Oh, absolutely, without a doubt. Put me on the mailing list, I'll show up to the next event.
So what's your name again?
Rudin Yepi.
How you spell it?
Rudin. Yepi, NGNEPI.
Thank you very much. You are with Ibrahim. How's about Ibrahim?
Ibrahim Aminu Zumunchi, all this what you know, in the United States since 2000, going back in Africa, come back. And what I really love with this is I just find out that we African people, we don't know each other. So, and we don't know which ground. The way we challenge and the way we struggle from country to country. We have Anglophones, we have Francophones. And they don't know how we operate. We don't know how. So today I heard a lot of stuff. I said, oh, let's talk. And so this is the beginning of lightening African people mind, and you have to be part of it.
So what do you like the most about this event?
What I like the most about it is I can talk to somebody from South Africa, and then I can speak English, and I can see even English speaking country now, they speak French. And something else I just learned, I never know about, like Sao Tome. But I met a guy from Sao Tome. I told him about a lot of stuff happening in Niger, in Francophone countries. He was like, yes. So he told me about the way things happening over there. I was like, oh, so this is what we need to do. We have one specter is chasing us because we don't know each other. So now, if we know each other, we can face the specter that chasing us. Start facing him is already a challenge. Let's do it.
So what's your name again?
Abraham Aminu.
Thank you very much.
Zumunchi, music, education, food and beverage, everything.
Thank you very much.
Wonderful. It was well planned, well organized. And it was so beautiful meeting my colleagues and my brothers and sisters from Africa this evening. And one of the highlights for me was actually seeing that there are young people who have a heart for the diaspora as well as for the homeland. And so there are many of us here in America who have a heart for the diaspora as well as our homeland and for Africa. So it's just really good to have everyone come together and find out ways that we can synergistically move things forward. And of course, the more that we speak about our countries and our experiences, the more that we really have in common. So it's really wonderful to be here today in Austin, Texas, July 26, 2015, with these new upcoming leaders and to be in an office position to be able to help them grow and give them a perspective on America as well as on policies that need to be changed that perhaps they haven't thought about. So it's been a wonderful evening.
What's your name?
I'm LaTanya Pegues, and I'm the owner of Boaz Enterprises. We do different types of international marketing, professional development, and public relations services as well as consulting. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So for the camera, so we can get it kind of in order, what do you do under YALI?
I'm part of the business and entrepreneurship track.
Okay.
So I'm sure you have heard from all my colleagues. We 25 of us are at UT at the moment doing the business and entrepreneurship track. Okay. I'm from Zimbabwe, and I'm a social entrepreneur. So the business and entrepreneurship track is sort of targeted at sharpening our business skills and just exposing us to new ways of thinking and possibly new ways of improving our businesses back home.
Okay, and when you finish, what are your dreams and desires to take back with you?
Yeah, so I work in rural health and education, and what I hope that I've learned in the last 5 to 6 weeks, I hope I've been equipped to sort of deal with challenges differently. Because sometimes when you're in a certain space, you only see it a certain way, but sometimes you need to take a step back and just learn different. And not only from the program, but even from my
So this is exciting. You're getting ready to meet President Barack Obama. How do you feel about that?
It's very exciting. I feel very honored.
Yes, this is amazing. Barack Obama created this network for you guys, and I think it's amazing that this network is actually impacting and empowering people's lives. And are you actually able to take and get something out of it and just spread the knowledge? Just been talking with different people of a fellow, and you guys all have big dreams. And you guys, as far as what I know now, everyone is going to be traveling back to their hometown and bringing what they're learning out of this program out. And so how does the program work as far as the cycle? How long have you been in the program? And how do you feel like it's impacted you personally?
Okay, so the program sort of, the program begins with the whole application process and that obviously is an application process for someone who wants to get out. And then the program continues on for everybody should follow Fairdies from previous years, because they do amazing things. I know the 2014 Fairdies, which grew, have mentored us up until this stage, they do amazing things as well. So they are in Kenya at the moment. I know a lot of us Zimbabwean are in Kenya. I have to say that. I'm Kenya at the moment, on the Global Entrepreneurship Summit. So it's giving them a platform, definitely, to scale up their businesses, to scale up their portfolios, and to be heard.
Okay. Was there anything else you want to say to the camera, anything you feel like you want to point out? Go ahead. Anywhere we can reach you, if you feel like you have something you want to keep us in contact with you, to reach you, anything big that you have going on that you know is going to bring impact later on, just anything else.
So we're currently running a project in rural education back in Zimbabwe. We're trying to bring technology into rural schools and trying to just the digital divide and gain more access to the schools. What I would like for everybody watching this is to just keep watching our stories, keep watching my story. Of course, that will push me to produce the results that I find, but it will also inspire people to keep the next, the next 10 years, Africa is going to be and I think keep watching this space, keep watching these young leaders.
Thank you so much for coming out. We enjoyed you.